Coming up on today's episode, I'm doing a collaboration with Belle Holiday Rose, and I'm going to show you how to make my Thanksgiving lentil loaf. She's going to show you how to make some side dishes, and you're going to have an amazing starch solution, fat-free holiday vegan meal. Let's get to the intro. Welcome back to another episode of Plant-Based Dads. I'm Joey. We are a vegan, whole food cooking channel. We do some product reviews. Lately, I'm doing something called the Starch Solution. Sometimes there's some baking with Tim, and there's some DIY. If you like what you hear so far, please hit that like button. Show us some love. And think about subscribing and becoming part of the Plant-Based Dads family. All right, so if you watch the channel for a while, you know that I'm doing the Starch Solution. The Starch Solution is a way of eating where you eat high-carb, whole food starches, low fats, and you lose weight. It's worked for me. I've lost 30 pounds on it, and I absolutely love the food, and I love eating till I'm full so I'm not starving myself like I did on so many other food programs. One of the things that's really helped me a lot is being surrounded by people who are like-minded, who are doing the same thing I am. And that is our Facebook group, Plant-Based Dads, Starch Solution Enthusiasts. It's just a bunch of people supporting each other on the Starch Solution, posting photos of their meals, telling what's worked for them, what hasn't worked for them, and a lot of people sharing their stories about how their health got better and, you know, they've lost weight and, you know, their cholesterol's dropped and all that stuff. A lot of really good inspiration in that group. So if you're on Facebook, you haven't joined the group, Plant-Based Dads, Starch Solution Enthusiasts, you can see it right here. Send a message to join. I'm one of the administrators. I'll let you in, and you can pick it up from there. Today's a big day because not only is it the Thanksgiving video I'm about to show you, but we also have a new challenge starting. It's a 21-day holiday challenge. And what we're doing this time is, I don't really want to focus so much on weight loss, although that's what the challenges are about. That's why people do them. But I really want to focus on, you know, going over the things we've learned in the past challenges. Meal prepping for the week. Make sure your plates are 50-50 or a 25-75 if you're not trying to lose weight. All right, so today's video is amazing. I'm going to be doing a Thanksgiving collaboration with a friend of mine, Belle Holiday Rose. She's got a YouTube channel right here. You can check her out. I'm going to be doing the Thanksgiving entree, and then she's going to be doing some side dishes that go along with it. And if you watch both videos, you'll get a really good idea of what a vegan, plant-based Thanksgiving looks like that doesn't have any oil on it and doesn't have any fat. Belle's been a vegan since 2007. She is a wonderful artist who does a lot of monster art, and she surrounds herself, if you've ever seen her apartment, you want to check it out, she surrounds herself with pop culture, horror, iconic stuff in her apartment. If you're into that whole macabre horror genre of film and TV, you will absolutely love her style. She's amazing, and she's so much fun to watch. All right, guys, so today's video, my Thanksgiving entree is an amazing lentil loaf. I've been making this loaf for years. So this loaf is actually High Carb Hannah's recipe from a few years ago. I know she doesn't need me to plug her channel. She's got like a million subscribers, but she needs to call me, right? And I tried this a few years ago and I loved it. And then after that, every year for the holidays, I would try other lentil loaves. And I always go back to this one. This one really is the best. I've modified it a little bit. I don't use her sauce. Her sauce is just ketchup. I need something more than that. But this lentil loaf is satisfying. It's robust. It's thick. And it really, really imitates meatloaf, right? I don't like my food to imitate meat. That's not something I do. But that's the closest I remember to meatloaf. All right, I'm really excited to show you how this turned out. You're not gonna believe how easy this is. Don't forget to check out Belle Holiday Rose's channel for the accompanying side dishes. Let's get to the food. Our lentil loaf starts with a flax egg. Here I'm putting 3 tablespoons of ground flaxseed into a little bowl and adding 6 tablespoons of filtered water. Then I'm gonna use my little mini whisk and whisk it all up. And then I'm gonna put it aside for 10 minutes to set. Next, I'm gonna ground up some oats to make some oat flour. I'm taking 1.5 cups of original oats and I'm tossing it in my little mini Cuisinart food processor. I love this thing. And I'm just gonna process it until it becomes a really fine flour mixture. It took about 30 seconds. You can see right here, it's ready to go. For the next step, I'm starting with the stock pot on the cooktop and apparently the leg of my tripod. I'm tossing in 1 cup of rinsed brown dry lentils, which are actually wet because I rinsed them off, but they're a bag of dry lentils. And then I'm also tossing in 1/2 cup of dry red lentils. Again, I rinsed them off. Next, I've got 4 to 6 cloves of garlic, really minced up well. Everything that you're throwing in here as far as veggies has to be really small and finely diced. So here I've got 1 onion finely diced, and now I'm throwing in 1 bell pepper finely diced, 1 carrot finely diced, and 2 to 4 celery stalks, again, finely diced. Next, I'm adding 3 cups of filtered water. Now I'm giving that a good stir, and I'm turning my burner on to medium heat. I'm gonna bring this to a nice boil, like you can see here, and then I'm gonna take the cover and fit it on nice and tight. I'm turning the heat down to low, and I'm gonna let it simmer for 30 minutes. The idea is for the lentils to completely absorb the water. After 30 minutes was up, I took off the cover, I gave it a good stir, and you can see here, I mean, there's hardly any water left. These lentils, they did the job. They absorbed all that water, and it looks amazing. It absolutely smells amazing too. This is ready to go. Now you can kind of eat this just like this, but we're going to make a loaf out of it. In a large mixing bowl, I'm tossing in 1 teaspoon of fennel seeds, 1 teaspoon of dried thyme, 1/2 teaspoon of onion powder, 1 tablespoon of Italian seasoning, and now I'm tossing in my flax egg. You can see the flax has become kind of this gelatinous mixture. This is what's gonna hold the whole loaf together. And now I'm giving that a good stir to mix up the flax egg with the spices here. You just wanna get that all combined. All right, now I'm dumping in my slightly cooled lentils. Everything I made in that pot is getting dumped right in here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and start mixing it together to incorporate that whole flax egg seasoning mixture throughout the whole bowl. Now I'm gonna add my oats. I didn't add the whole thing at once. I wanted to see if I needed all of it, so I put part of it in. And you can see here, I'm just kind of stirring it up and incorporating it. And as I'm incorporating, I realize I do need it all. So then I take the rest of the oats from the container and throw those in also. And I start incorporating that too. It eventually starts absorbing the oat and starts looking like a traditional loaf mixture. You can see here that it's a really good consistency. This is easily moldable in the shape that it's in right now. All right, so I move that aside and I break out my loaf pan, and I'm putting in a little paper sling here so I can easily pull this out without any problem and to make easy cleanup later on. I'm just gonna start spooning the mixture into the loaf pan until I filled the pan up to the top. You can see here I'm just doing a little bit at a time, and now I'm taking the spoon to kind of flatten it all out on the top. So now I'm gonna put this in a preheated oven at 350 degrees, and I'm gonna let it cook for 30 minutes. Now, I actually had too much mix to put in this loaf pan. I need a bigger loaf pan. So I made a separate casserole, hot dish, which gives me something to eat because I wanna save the actual loaf for the video. While that's happening, I'm gonna make my own topping for this. I'm starting with 1/3 cup of organic ketchup, and then I'm adding 1 tablespoon of maple syrup. After that, I'm adding 1 tablespoon of balsamic vinegar. And now I'm gonna use my whisk and start mixing that all together till it's incorporated, so it's a ketchup-based sauce. After 30 minutes, I'm taking my loaves out of the oven, as you can see here, and then I'm taking my topping, and I'm brushing it on, okay, I'm pouring it on, and then brushing it along the top of the loaf. Again, you can do this before you put them in the oven the first time, but I like to cook it first and then lay the topping on so the topping doesn't burn. I've put plenty on, and I've doubled the recipe for that topping because I like to have it throughout the week. Now it's going back in the oven for 15 minutes just so the topping can get incorporated into the top of the loaf. And as I'm pulling it out here, you can see this looks absolutely beautiful, right? You've got a wonderful loaf there with an amazing topping. You can see here how good it looks. It looks like a traditional meatloaf. I'm taking this out of the pan now with the paper sling. Now I've got my beautiful dollar store pumpkin platter here, right? You know I love the dollar store, and I'm putting my loaf on my little pumpkin platter. Yes, it's really kind of too small for this platter, but I wanted to use this thing in the video so you can see what a great deal I got at the dollar store. Now I'm gonna start slicing this up, and you can see here, once the slice goes through and you see it fall forward, the loaf is just absolutely beautiful. It came out amazing. The lentils, I mean, it just imitates, you know, a traditional style loaf that you would have on Thanksgiving. This is gonna be a very hearty, delicious meal. And here you have it, guys, your lentil holiday loaf. It's ready to eat, so good. I wish you could smell this. The whole house just smells of this loaf. It's so enticing. It looks like a really nice, thick loaf. You can see I've lathered it with sauce, right? When I make that sauce, I double the recipe. Every time I heat it up, I want to pour some fresh sauce over it just to kind of freshen it up because I like the sauce. All right, let's give this a taste and see how it is. Mmm. This is absolutely amazing. So good, guys. So good. When I was a meat eater, Thanksgiving was about the sides. I didn't care about the turkey. I wanted the mashed potatoes. I wanted the gravy. I wanted the stuffing. I wanted all that stuff, right? The turkey was just kind of an annoyance to me, right? And my family would be like, you have to eat the turkey. I'm like, I don't care about the turkey. I want the sides, right? I should have seen it back then. All right, guys, that's our video for today. Holiday lentil loaf. I'll put a link to the blog post on High Carb Hannah's blog on how to make this so you have the recipe. And don't forget to check out Belle Holiday Rose's video on how to make the accompanying side dishes with this. They are absolutely delicious looking and you're gonna wanna make those too. Over the next few weeks, I'm gonna have some more holiday side dish videos for you, so check those out. All right, guys, hit that like button. Show us some love. What's not to like? We've got a beautiful lentil loaf here. Don't forget to subscribe and become part of the Plant-Based Dads family. If you click that bell, you'll get notified every time we have a new video, usually every Monday. If there's a DIY, that'll be on Wednesday. And if there's Baking with Tim or anything else, that'll be on Saturdays. And please leave a comment. What are you doing for Thanksgiving? Or Thanksgiving, as we like to call it. Are you making something other than a lentil loaf? I was going to make lasagna instead, but I decided to make this. And I'm probably going to do lasagna for the winter holidays. So keep an eye out for that. But I would love to know what you're doing. Are you on the starch solution with me? Are we doing it together? Let me know. I would love to hear it. I really do well when I've got others on my team. All right, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.